Hello everyone, welcome back. Today we're going to make this turn the page transition that you see on the screen right now. This is inspired by Essentials Video Editing. She made this originally. I'm going to make it a little bit different by using anim curves. I thought my subscribers might like this one, so I figured I'd do it. I'm going to demonstrate that the transition will not stick in the right spot yet. There will be a free preset in the description below. It'll only go to the right. This happens with video only. If it's a still, you won't have the issue. It's because we're at the end of the video. You have to have those handles. You can do it this way. Or select this tool here. Or you can do it that way. We'll start out with a cross dissolve. Now it's in the right spot. Right click on the cross dissolve. Select Convert to Fusion Cross Dissolve. Then this little wand thing will show up. Select it to go to Fusion. You can delete the Cross Dissolve. Bring the Media in 2, below the Media in 1. Get an Image Plane. Get a merge. I have to use this on-screen keyboard because I'm paralyzed. I can't use my hands and arms. So we'll be up there in the way from time to time. Trust me, it annoys me more than it will you. Shift space and bender. And select the minor node. And a merge and a render. Select the render. Go to render type. Change it from software to hardware. Now it'll optimize the render time when you render the cache. Get another image plane. Select the first one, go to transform, and then pin it. Select the second one, open a transform, and pin it. We're going to connect the scale to both these, so right click on the scale on the bottom, expression, grab the pick whip, carry it over, and connect it to the scale on the top one. We'll go to one viewer and open it all the way. On the top one, change the scale to 2.95. And it should fit. Select the bender node. Then go to the axis. Select the X. An angle. Put in 90. I'm going to go to two viewers. With the merge. Viewer 1. And take the amount all the way up. You will see what's going on in viewer 1 now. Then take the center all the way to the left. That way it pivots from the left side. And we're going to animate it with the range. With the anim curves. You would think you could right click on the range and select the anim curves and it'll work that way, but it don't. You have to right click on whatever side of the slider you want to use. We want this one, so right click, modify width, anim curves. Now if you scrub the playhead, you'll see it's working, but it's backward. Go to the modifier up here, and check invert. Now, should we go in the correct way? Connect the image plane 2 into the merge. We're going to connect both those image planes to the merge 2. Select the merge 2. Let's unpin both these first. And then select the merge. Open the transform. Pin it. Select the first image plane on the bottom. And the bottom one, put it minus 30 on the z-axis. And then right click on the z. Expression. Take the pick whip up and connect it to the z on top. Double click on it, open the top one, make sure it's the image plane, and put in 30. And select the second image plane, the top one. We're going to do the same thing. Grab the pick whip, bring it up to Z, and connect it. Then double click up here, open it back up, and put in 30. Come back down to the bottom one on the expression, put a minus in front of the eye, right at the very, very beginning. Okay. Let's unpin that, click away, and select the top image plane. Go to controls. Make this so you can see it. Go to controls, visibility, and select front on the top one, which is the image plane 2. I forgot to turn the subdivisions all the way up to the right on both the image planes. Now only the back. Select the image plane 1. Go to controls, visibility, back. Go back to the image plane 2. Go to materials and select the default color for the back. Bring media out down here. Get a 2D merge. Pipe the media in 2 into the background of the merge. And the render into the foreground. Select the render. Shift space and drop shadow. We'll go make sure it's working okay. Looks good. Now to go back, you gotta do it here. Okay, we're ready to make the macro. Start up in the corner here. Highlight them like I do. Right click on any one of them. Make sure you do not include the two media ins and the media out. Go to macro, create macro, give it a name. And follow along. That's to turn the color of the back on and off. In front of color, put in back. On the render, go to common, We're going to add a blur. Drop shadow. We only need shadow strength. Go to file. Save as group. It takes you to macros. Go to fusion instead. Templates. Edit. Transitions. Here's where you're going to want to make a folder. Put your preset in. Once again, name it different than the preset. If it's exactly the same, Resolve won't recognize it. So put an underscore or something in there. If you can't find it, you may have to restart Resolve. Here it is. We'll make it longer, just stretch it out. Or you can come up here in the inspector and do it here, like normal. You can make it back transparent or add the color. Add motion blur. Keep in mind, motion blur uses a lot of resources on a computer. It'll take a lot longer to render out, and it may not play smooth in DaVinci, but when you render it out, save it, it normally will. Well, there you go. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.